The country of Afghanistan, formerly known as the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, has captured news headlines all over the world. But there is so much more to Afghanistan than all the negative things that make the news headlines. What's happening, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Four Door Facts. And now we are about to look at 10 surprising and interesting facts about Afghanistan. So let's take a look. I mean, the country is filled with a lot of amazing things, and I want to highlight that for you guys. Now the first thing to look at is the landlocked country of Afghanistan shares its borders with Pakistan, China, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Iran and Uzbekistan, and has a huge population of 38.2 million people, making it the 37th most populated country in the world. Now the people who make up Afghanistan, they are called Afghans, not Afghanis, which is the currency that they use, and it's a common mistake that people make. The next thing is that the country Afghanistan is the world's 42nd largest by land area, with Kabul serving as its capital and largest city. The total land area is 652,860 square meter, and human habitation in Afghanistan dates back to the Middle Paleolithic era, and the country's strategic location along the Silk Road connected it to cultures of the Middle East as well as other parts of Asia. Afghanistan's national game is buz, kashi, which literally translates to go pulling, and they want this to be an Olympic sport. Good luck with that, because it's regarded as the wildest sports game out there. It involves placing the carcass of a goat and calf or sheep placed in the center of a circle, which is surrounded by players of two teams who are on horseback. The objective of the game is to pick up the carcass and bring it across a goal line or into the winner's circle. The game had been played since the 13th century and used to be played earlier by rich rival warlords, but it's now being financed by phone companies as well as private airlines. Also, carpet weaving has always been an integral part of the Afghan heritage for centuries, with ethnic diversity drawn from other cultures like Iran, Pakistan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan. The Afghan drugs are an extremely popular Afghanistan export in 2008, 2013 and 2014, and rags want international awards, which are held every year in Hamburg, Germany. Most and weavers today make rugs that are about the same as those that have been woven for decades, and as a testament to the meticulous. It's also the land of opium and is the largest and fastest growing produce in Afghanistan. Afghanistan opium poppy production goes into more than 90% of heroin worldwide. Afghanistan has been the world's greatest illicit opium producer, and in 2017 opium cultivation in Afghanistan reached a record high. The fact that the opium poppy cultivation continues to expand in Afghanistan is not surprising. Another interesting fact is that the world's first oil paintings, but not drawn in Renaissance Europe contrary to popular belief, but in the caves of Bamiyan, located in the central heartland of Afghanistan around 650 BC in 2008. Scientists discovered oil paintings in 12 out of 50 caves in Bamiyan, possibly made with walnut or poppy. Bamiyan was once a thriving Buddhist center where monks lived in a series of caves carved into the cliffs by the two statues. This was the spot where the world's two largest standing Buddha statues once stored, until the Taliban destroyed them in 2001, seeing that the statues were on Islamic. Poetry is also a very important part of Afghan culture for thousands of years. Afghans have told their tales in the form of verses in the western side of Here at Thursday is a poetry night every Thursday. People from all across the city get together to share verses from old and new poetry, and they get together with desserts and sweet tea and bond over poetry. That sounds pretty awesome. The next thing I want to talk about is the Kandahar airfield, situated in southern Afghanistan, is known to be the world's single busiest Rangrear strip. It is also the location where NATO has its first full air traffic facility in a country not listed in NATO. And the final fact about Afghanistan is that Afghanistan and became independent on August 19th of 1919, and they fought three words with Britain. After which they declare themselves independent. Now interesting. They were never directly ruled by the British, however, like every other country in South Asia. Their foreign affairs were heavily influenced by the United Kingdom, nicknamed the Graveyard of Empires. Afghanistan has had a reputation for being an unconquered ball and for doing ambitious military ventures and humiliating would-be conquerors. The Soviets also tried to invade Afghanistan, but they were forced out. Afghans did not give in. So that was the brief look at the country Afghanistan. Let me know all of your thoughts and comments down below in the comments section, and also let me know which country you would like to see on FD episode next. If you enjoyed this video, you definitely like, share and subscribe.